Welcome. In today's video, I'll be explaining about the mechanisms that reverse the DNA damage. It includes photoreactivation by photolysis enzyme and using methyl transferase, the DNA damage can be reversed. Okay, they both are examples for direct reverse. So direct repair system, it means that DNA repair mechanisms that corrects the DNA damage without removing the base or nucleotide, then it will be referred to as direct repair system. So the best example for direct repair system will be photoreactivation of thymine dimers. Okay, I'll be giving an example with photoreactivation which involved in cyanobacteria. So this cyanobacteria, which is exposed to several environmental stresses including the UV radiation, will result in DNA damage. So one of the best repair mechanism is photoreactivation, which is found in the cyanobacteria, and it utilizes the enzyme photolysis for reverting the modified bases into normal form. The survival of the organism is increased to several fold times if it was exposed to visible light. That mechanism is called as photoreactivation, that is light repair. Okay, and it is very important for DNA repair mechanisms. In this photoreactivation, it utilizes DNA photolysis, which employ a blue wavelength of solar light for correcting or reversing the modified nitrogenous bases to their normal state. These photolysis contain two non-covalent factors, FAD and MTFH, methylene tetrafolate, okay, tetrahydrofolate. These photolysis are flavor proteins belonging to photolysis cryptochrome CRY CPF superfamily, which utilize a cofactor FAD for repairing the UVR induced modified bases with the help of the light wavelength in the range of 360 to 530 nanometer, with cryptochromes acting as photoreceptors. This photoreactivation is a three-step process that repairs the dipyrimidine lesion. So in the first step, the photolysis scans the DNA molecule and gets bind with the dimer. So after the identification of the lesion, this photolysis will go and bind with the dimer. This is the first step. Then in the second step, the photolysis dimer complex will absorb a quantum of light within the range of 350 to 500 nanometer. And in the third step, the bound photolysis is released from the DNA molecule. Thus, the DNA damage is reversed. The mechanism, what is involved in this photoreactivation photolysis is, this photolysis or enzymes, which contains two non-covalent factors, FAD and MTHF, that is methylene tetrahydrofolate. This methylene tetrahydrofolate absorbs visible light. Okay, this will absorb visible light with a range of 350 to 500 nanometer and gets excited. This in turn will transduce the energy or photon to this FAD molecule, so thus this FAD will be reduced into FADH2. After received the energy from MTHF, it gets reduced into FADH2, which in turn transfers the high energy of electrons to pyrimidine dimer. So the lesion, okay, the photolysis which is now bound with the pyrimidine dimer uses this energy which is given out by this FADH2 to break this pyrimidine dimer. So after breaking the pyrimidine dimer, the DNA damage is reversed. This is how the DNA damage get reversed through photoreactivation. So this is the phenomenon. So photolysis will find this lesion. It will go and bind with the lesion. This is the dimer. Okay, so it will find with the lesion. Then this FAD will get reduced into FADH2 with the help of MTHF, okay, methylene tetrahydrofolate. This will donate the energy to FAD to get reduced into FADH2. This in turn, after absorbing the wavelength of 300 to 500 nanometer, the methylene tetrahydrofolate will after excitation it will transduce the energy of photons into FAD to be converted into FADH2. Then it in turn forward this energy to this dimer to break open. This energy will be utilized to break this dimer, making this lesion into a correct form. Okay, now this DNA damage has been reversed with using light mechanism. Okay, then this is called as direct reverse by photolyase. So in this DNA photolyase, the pyrimidine dimer lesions bind through dinucleotide flipping mechanism. Okay, prior to the repair, the pyrimidine dimer is flipped outwards into active site cavity containing the cofactor FADH. These two cofactors FAD and methylene tetrahydrofolate will play a vital function in the enzyme catalysis of PHRA gene, which codes for specific DNA photolyase is involved in this mechanism. It was found that cells which lack this gene were highly sensitive to UVB radiations. This photolyase are classified into two main broad classes. Photolyase which use light energy for identifying, for repairing the UVR generated photo product functions in DNA. Or the other class of this photolyase is CRYS, which function in a blue light dependent as well as independent way to regulate the processes such as transcriptional regulations in cyanobacteria. Okay, so this is the mechanism involved in direct reversal by photolyase. Next method of example for direct reverse is using methyl transferase. So this mechanism acts on lesions which occurs from alkylation. The guanine and thymine residues of DNA are the most vulnerable bases by alkylating agents. Alkylation of guanine and thymine results in the formation of O6-methylguanine and O4-methylthymine. The ADA gene is involved in this reaction. This ADA codes for this methyl transferase enzyme, which helps to reverse the DNA damage by transferring the methyl or alkyl groups from this O6-methylguanine or O4-methylthymine to itself, to the enzyme itself, so that it gets reversed. That is, this methyl transferase reverse process involves two steps. First, this ADA methyl transferase will scan for this methyl guanine or methyl thymine residues, and then it will go and bind with that lesion. So in the, it will scan, this methyl transferase will go and scan for this lesions where methyl group is attached, any alkyl group is attached to the bases. So it will scan for this methyl guanine or methyl thymine. It will go and bind tightly with that. It will trap that methyl group. That is the second step. The alkyl group is transferred from the guanine to this methyl transferase enzyme. Then the methyl transferase, after accepting the alkyl group, it gets inactivated or get degraded. After the alkyl group, this guanine and thymine resumes their normal hydrogen bonding and gets, thus it is reversed. So these are the two best examples for direct reverse systems. One is methyl, using methyl transferase enzyme, we can without any that is, the damaged DNA is been repaired without the removal of any bases or nucleotides. Okay, so the one method is by using methyl transferase. The other best method is by photo reactivation by photolyase enzyme. So the summary of direct reverse mechanism is photo reactivation will identify pyrimidine dimers, and it will reverse this damage using the enzyme photolyase. The genes involved are PHRA and PHRB genes. Methyl transferase is another example for direct reverse mechanism which identifies the alkylated bases, mainly the methyl guanine or methyl thymine. The enzyme involved here is methyl transferase, which will which helps to remove this methyl residues from guanine and thymine, thus resetting back the thymine and guanine for normal hydrogen bonding. The gene involved here is ADA gene. So photoreactivation is a robust mechanism which is found in the cyanobacteria, which is one of the main reason of its higher UV tolerance. Probably during the daytime, the photoreactivation plays a crucial role in the repair of dimer, and it takes lesser time to accomplish the task. Hope you would have understood the concepts of mechanisms which are involved in direct reversal systems. Thank you for watching this video. Subscribe and support the channel Biochemistry DSP.